Stand up. Stand up for your rights. Get up, stand up. Don't give up the fight. Get up, stand up. Stand up for your rights. Get up, stand up. Don't give up the fight. You preacher man, don't tell me.
There has been a major attack in the last few months on the whole issue of ill health and injury pensions in the UK Fire Service. I mean, there has been an attack on the ability of people to be able to retire early for some years now. But I think what's happened in the last few months has been absolutely staggering. That we've actually had three of our members who have retired who have now had their pensions stopped. So they're now in the position where through no fault of their own, and at least two of the three, it's through the fault of the fire authority because of the work that they were requiring our members to carry out. Those members were not fit enough to continue with their jobs, and they've been told that they're medically unfit to continue, yet they cannot have a pension either. And there's now another case that has arisen that not everybody may be aware of yet, but it was reported in the Sunday Telegraph a couple of weeks ago. A retained duty member in Nottinghamshire, who as a result of an injury that he has sustained at work, can no longer do his primary employment. Looks like he's not going to be able to continue as a retained firefighter either, and is being told by that brigade that he will be sacked on capability grounds, and he'll be left with no compensation for having lost his primary employment or his secondary employment. And all those fire authorities struggling with the issue of retained recruitment, well, if they think that that sort of message is going to encourage people to join the retained fire service, they really had better think again. It is the most important issue that this union has faced for some considerable time, and it's one that we have to be successful on. And that's why we've organised this meeting here today. And the first person to be speaking on it is Martin Marrion, a former London member who is one of those three who has had their pension stopped, and Martin's going to explain the situation as it's facing him.
First thing I'll say is the reason I come up and do this talk, I spoke at Whatley Hall as well, is it would be very easy to think of me or us three as just a statistic. And I wanted you to actually see that there's a face behind the name. I joined in 1979 and I was based at Knightsbridge Fire Station, and we went to lots of fires, and it turned out that one of the fires injured my ears, which I had no idea that happened. Back in 98, after failing many medicals because of my hearing, they put me on an annual sort of report, so I was coming back every 6 months to a year doing more and more hearing tests. Finally, they decided that my hearing was so bad, they sent me to their expert, a lady called Professor Luxon, who, like most people would do, I guess, I Googled her, and she is one of the top specialists in the country, probably in the world. And she did a barrage of tests. And this isn't like a normal hearing test. You don't press a button on this one. There's conclusive evidence of what happened, when it happened, and how bad my hearing was. She then told me that not only could I not carry on as a firefighter, but I could never return to a fire station from that moment onwards, because the sound of the sirens or the call bells would further damage my hearing. The authority then decided that they were going to retire me on ill health. What I should say is that Professor Luxon determined that my hearing was damaged at the Italian consulate fire in 1980. I mean, that's well over 20 something years before, but she was able to actually pinpoint it. The brigade accepted everything. They actually retired me out on a due to service injury and gave me a 25% disability. They also told me that my hearing is progressive and I would eventually go completely deaf. The hearing test they did my assessment on was an old one. So I asked five times in writing to be reassessed so that my percentage could go up. I didn't want to appeal, I just want to be reassessed. And they kept refusing, so in the end I had no choice, but I appealed. As everyone knows, when you appeal, the board has a specific question. Nothing else, just one question. And my question they had to agree on or look at was, could my degree of disability be increased? At that hearing, they decided not to look at that question. They decided to look at another question completely, which was, should I have been permanently retired in the first place? They then wrote to me and said that, no, I should never have been retired, and therefore they're sending my case back to my authority. The union and got together with Thompson's and decided to put together a judicial review to challenge that. And all that time I was getting paid my pension until the judicial review came up. Then the London Fire Authority decided, through advice they had got, to just retire, refuse to pay my pension. I got 1 week's notice. I don't know what anybody here would do if they got 1 week's notice saying they weren't going to be paid anymore. I never wanted to retire in the first place. I had just taken out a large mortgage. We had, at our age, just about bought what we considered to be our dream home. I missed two mortgage payments, and the mortgage company decided to repossess. I talked to them. I said, this is a no-brainer, at least let me sell the house and that way everyone can get something. Lucky enough, the union, locally and nationally, have come up with some money from hardship fund for me, Andy Scott and Neil Burke, the other two, and my house is now off the market. So for the next month or so, I'm safe. This is going to happen. There are no more ill health pensions. Every time the fire bell goes, you have to ask yourself, if I get injured here, I'm not going to get a pension. And as far as I can see, I mean, I know for two other guys, they're taking it really, really bad. For me, I'm going to lose everything. I have to say also, even if the judicial review comes forward and they reinstate my pension, I could then get a letter saying they want me back up to be reassessed, and then they could then say, we have to decide to redeploy you, there's no jobs, and we're now sacking you. So even if I win my personal case, chances are they're going to sack me, unless we can win the big case, which is the changing of the wording, which I'll leave Matt and Doug to talk about. But that's my case. I'm just a firefighter who didn't want to retire, was forced to retire. I'm going to be deaf. Through no fault of mine, I've lost everything. It shouldn't happen, and it shouldn't happen to anyone else.
Get up, stand up. Stand up for your rights. Get up, stand up. Don't give up.